My primary area is in applied mathematics, but also focused on environmental science and biological systems.
My main research and teaching focus is groundwater or hydrogeology.
Research we study here at App is related to the effects of atmospheric aerosols.
I teach cartographic design and analysis, or map making.
I teach Civil War and military history, primarily.
My area of specialty is forest ecology.
I'm a biogeographer, so I look at how our environment is recorded in trees.
I have a special concentration in environmental philosophy and animal ethics.
My research focuses on studying glaciers.
My area that I research and teach in is environmental policy. I think it's very important for our students who come to Appalachian State and are interested in environmental policy to recognize the importance of multiple perspectives, multiple methods, and values that all interplay in planning and decision making that is essential for building resilience and addressing sustainability.
Environmental thinking should be part of all of our thinking, because none of the things we're doing, geography, planning, political science, philosophy, can happen without the environment. We're going to have to be forced by environmental factors to change the way that we live. And the question now is, how do we prepare ourselves to do that?
Students have a unique opportunity to actively contribute to climate change research. App is one of only two sites in the country that has the collection of NOAA and NASA network instruments that's capable of quantifying the aerosol direct effect on climate.
I might be biased, but I think glaciers are actually one of the most important parts of the entire Earth system. And my research focuses on studying glaciers, how they've shaped landscapes in the past, and how they will change in the future in a warming climate.
When we think about global change, we often think about climate change. And that is a very important global change, but there are other things that are happening at the same time. So we are losing biodiversity faster than at any time in the past, at least 65 million years. So the last mass extinction was all the cool dinosaurs died. We're in another extinction period right now. So the things that are driving the current mass extinction are climate change is one of them, and then land use change is the second big thing. And land use change is one of those things that remote sensing is really good at measuring. We really did not have a good grasp of how much humans changed the surface of the Earth until we started looking at, you know, pictures from space and from larger scales.
As a geographer, I'm really trained to examine patterns over time, and I'm specifically focused on precipitation in mountain regions and how that's tied to things like water resources, ecosystem services, and things that human societies really rely on.
My main research and teaching focus is groundwater or hydrogeology, taking advantage of sort of the high mountains we have up here near Boone and looking at wetlands that belong sort of on top of those mountains and looking at the creatures, things like these little bog turtles that are the size of your palm that live up there, and thinking about how their habitat's changing as our climate warms.
Dr. Tim Silver and I, as an environmental historian, and he and I have been working on an environmental history of the Civil War. How does the environment shape a campaign? How does a campaign alter the landscape? What historians can do is sort of place those things in context. Let's look at the mistakes that we've made in the past, and we can learn how it affected those people. And let's try to use our knowledge of the past effectively to recognize what questions to even ask, and not only what mistakes to avoid.
I mean, there's all sorts of possibilities here when you start thinking creatively about it. We could redesign our society in better, more efficient, more flourishing, more human ways. So I hope that's what happens. And I think this is why lots of departments are doing some form of sustainability, is because there's just no part of our sort of intellectual, social, political, economic life that isn't touched and changed by these sorts of problems.
I would say Appalachian is the perfect fit for any student that enjoys being in the environment and learning about the environment scientifically. What my goal is as a professor is to have our students graduate as critical thinkers, data-driven, and problem-solving. And that relates to the environment, that relates to how we see the world, and that relates to being a global citizen. I think our students are so impressive here at App State because they're really passionate about the environment. And they often have questions about where is this data coming from and how do we interpret it and how do we know that the changes we're seeing will last.
There are so many people that are interested in environmental and sustainable issues that anywhere you go, you can talk to someone about them and find some commonality. And so we have a college that's full of really interested people that you can collaborate with and get ideas from, and a lot of very energetic students that are really, really talented.